He has already seated us in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. And we want to stay where he is. He that dwells in his secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. To be where he is.
Hallelujah.
I don't think nobody here the Lord. I say it's a good place to be where he is. That's so good to Paul. Paul say, in him I learned to live. In him I learned to move. And in him I learned to have my being. In other words, I just want to be where you are. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I wish I had about five people that was excited about your Savior and your Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah. Hallelujah. God is an awesome God. Sometimes, and we're ready to get in the word. Give the Lord about 20 minutes of the time he gave you to live in the earth. So too often we're rushing God through a lot of that. You know, it's amazing that the world has conditioned us. Brother Eric got up saying the scripture same way it said, be in the world, not of the world. That word world, cosmos in Greek. It talks about the order of government, the order of authority, or the order of this world system. It's amazing that you and I have been conditioned by the world, that when we go to several places of transaction, Mother Hackett, they don't have to tell us to do anything. We're so accustomed to doing it. The God and the Savior and the Lord that you proclaim to love so much.
Yes.
That we sometimes got to be pumped and primed, pushed and pressed.
Yes.
To give our manufacturer, the manufacturer and us being the product, must do his name. Now, if it don't take all of that for you, that's one thing. But don't just praise God when he put food on your table. Because he's greater than the food that's on your table. Oh, man. I'll be glad when the true church really arrives. Really arrives. Because we get so excited about a man or a person than the man. I ain't say we shouldn't honor folk. But I'm telling you without a shadow of a doubt, whether you've got a praise in your mouth or not, I'm going to take every opportunity that I have to give God a shout. Y'all sit down, y'all sit down, sit down, y'all sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down. You know, sometimes I believe we've been told about God so much that we really don't know him intimately ourselves. That we wait sometimes for certain conditions to be prevalent and present in order for us to give God what he has demanded us to give him. Now, don't you know that God deserves our praise? He demands our praise. He desires our praise. And then he will delight in your praise. I'm just wondering. I'm still trying to figure it out, preacher. How we can serve such an awesome God. And yet can a few of his children
got a hard time opening up our mouth, but when we talk on the phone, we don't have a problem.
See, y'all been listening to the wrong spirit. I ain't telling you to hang from the chandeliers. I ain't telling you to roll in the floor and snot and cry and all that. That ain't moving God. That's just moving you. But I wonder, when you look back over yesterday year,
Yeah.
Proverbs 19:21. We're going back to purpose because it's a lot of people in the hour and the season that we are in kingdom, that you better make sure that you got a personal and intimate relationship with the Lord. Because what is happening now? What is happening now is when you don't know who you are and your identity and what God called you to do, somebody else is going to dominate you with their words and try to tell you your purpose. God is trying to help you. Because when you don't know what God called you to do, you will settle for what everybody else will tell you to do that God didn't tell you. But not effective. Oh, listen to here. You gotta give account. Let's go around here. This is nobody. You and I gotta give account of the time that we spent in the earth and what we supposed to have done that we might not have done, and what you did. What he wanted you to do, and you still got to give account. So I'll say in a setting like this and others that before you practice what thus says the Lord on my life, make it work for yours first.
Loving the people.
And if the Lord can't use me to help you, I promise you, but I wouldn't save you, I wouldn't hurt you.
Yeah.
Kim, a lot of people don't understand a lot of things the Lord allowed to be done by the Spirit of God through me as pastor, but see, they're not pastors. Because they are on the outside. You're looking in. So you won't be deceived by Satan and his demons.
Yes.
So when you go back